ini ya iya nama
aku itu
slide
sekarang on live jale
sir
चल करेंगे
यस सर
शुरू करेंगे
चलो गाइस
ओके UI 8.4. Let us see the thyroid gland. It is situated in front of the larynx. It has got two lobes, right lobe and left lobe, and central isthmus. So let us see the what is the iodide trapping. So this diagram illustrates you that the iodine which is transported into the acinar cells, it forms iodide. So let us see the iodide is converted it into iodine in presence of peroxidase enzyme. It enters into the thyroglobulin, which helps the conversion of tyrosine into monoiodotyrosine and diiodotyrosine. Monoiodotyrosine is also called as MIT. Diiodotyrosine is called DIT. So one molecule of monoiodotyrosine combines with one molecule of DIT, it forms triiodothyronine. It's called T3. Two molecules of DIT combines the two molecules of DIT, it forms tetraiodothyronine. That's called T4. So how it is synthesized in the thyroglobulin? The normal plasma T4 is 8 microgram per deciliter and T3 is 0.15 microgram per deciliter. 99% T4 and T3 combined with proteins, they combine with thyrobinding globulin, thyroxine binding globulin, and also called as thyroid binding prealbumin and albumin. Only 1% total hormone is free from, it is physiologically active. Thyroid hormones are released slowly because they are bound to the proteins. T3 and T4 bind with intracellular proteins, they are slowly acts over a period of days or weeks. The secretion pituitary of TSH depends upon the pre-thyroid hormone level in the blood. Coming to the mode of action thyroid hormones before acting on the genes to increase the genetic transcription. Almost all the T4 molecules are converted into T3 molecules. T3 has got very high binding affinity for the cellular thyroid hormone receptors. The receptors are either attached to the DNA, genetic strands, or in close proximity to them. The TR is always bound to another receptor called retinoid X receptor, RXR. Exact role of RXR is not clear, but thyroid hormones bind to the receptors and forms the hormone receptor complex. This complex initiates the transcription of process by activating the enzymes such as RNA polymerase and phosphoprotein kinases. It also stimulates the synthesis of nuclear proteins. Thus, a large number of mRNA is formed, which activate the ribosomes to synthesize the new proteins. The proteins are involved in many activities, including the enzymatic actions. The functions of the thyroid hormone increase overall metabolic rate in the body, stimulate the growth in children. Coming to the actions one by one, on basal metabolic rate, the thyroid hormone is chelogenic action because it increases the metabolism of almost all the tissues in the body except brain and some parts. Thyroid hormones produced in excess can be increased the BMR about 60 to 100%. It also helps in the growth and development of the body, general growth, secretion of the growth hormone also. Coming to its metabolic activity, it acts on the various metabolism like carbohydrate metabolism, increase the absorption of glucose from the gut, increase the gluconeogenesis, and it also helps increases the insulin degradation, increase the glycogenolysis, breakdown of the glycogen. On the lipid metabolism, it is enhanced by thyroid hormones, increase the synthesis, mobilization of the lipids, degradation also, the decrease serum cholesterol level. On the protein metabolism, thyroid hormones are essential for the protein synthesis and the growth. It excess thyroid hormones lead to protein catabolism. On body weight also, it helps. That is, thyroid hormone decrease the body weight due to increase catabolism. On the heart, on the CVS, increases the heart rate, increases the force of contraction, increases systolic blood pressure, but decreases the diastolic blood pressure. But mean arterial pressure is unchanged. It also causes vasodilatation. Acting on other parts of the body like CNS, thyroid hormones have marked effect on the brain development. They help in the synaptic development and the myelination. They maintain the normal reaction time of stretch reflex. Excess of thyroxin causes stimulation of CNS, causing restlessness. It also helps on the sleep. Thyroid hormones maintain a normal sleep pattern, and particularly it is disturbed in hyperthyroidism. Excessive stimulation occurs in hyperthyroidism, and subject is unable to sleep also. It also helps in the muscles development, growth of the muscles, skeletal muscles, prevents the muscle weakness. It also maintains the skin, texture of the skin. It also helps in the reproductive system, maintain the normal cycle of the ovarian cycle in females, maintain the spermatogenesis in males. It also helps in the sexual function. Along with the other hormones, it has also got a permissive action with other hormones also. Coming to its regulation of thyroid gland, thyroid hormone secretion, as hypothalamus is stimulating the antipituitary by through TRH, and the TRH in further stimulates the antipituitary by TSH activity, thyroid stimulating hormone, which in turn stimulates the thyroid glands to secrete T3 and T4. Excessive T3 and T4 is regulated by, controlled by the hypothalamus and as well antepituitary. First, it suppresses the antepituitary gland by suppressing a TSS level, and it suppresses the hypothalamus by suppressing a TRH level. Thus, it brings a negative feedback mechanism. So, this is an example of negative feedback mechanism. Coming to the thyroid function test, there are various thyroid function tests: thyroid reductive iodine uptake test or isotope scan, estimation of hormones T3 and T4 level, determination of the protein bond iodine, metabolic test BMR, serum cholesterol and serum creatinine estimation, thyroid suppression test, TRH and TSH stimulation, estimation of TSH by RIA, measurement of antibodies against thyroid, ultrasound scan, Achilles reflex time, sleeping pulse rate, FNAC and thyroid biopsy. These are the various thyroid function tests. Coming to the applied physiology of thyroid gland, the various diseases which cause the abnormalities of thyroid secretion can be dealt either excessive secretion or deficiency hormones. Hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism. Deficiency of the hypothyroid hormone secretion causes hypothyroidism. There are two types of hypothyroidism. One is called myxedema hypothyroidism in adults. Second is called ketimism hypothyroidism in children. So coming to the diagram of myxedema, you can see the photography of the myxedema which is shown here. This patient has got myxedema. This is a condition of hypothyroid state. See the puffiness of the face. There is a non-pitting edema over the face, and edema is also seen near the eyelids. Loss of hairs for the eyelids, and there is a dry skin and intolerance to cold, hoarseness of voice, mental sluggishness, delayed reaction time and excessive sleep, decreased heart rate, reduced appetite, menstrual irregularity and infertility, low serum level of T3 and T4, whereas increased TSH level. The low T3 and T4 increased TSH level, diagnosing helping the, it is a hypothyroidism. So treatment is supplementation with hormone thyroxine. The another condition called hypothyroidism in children, so that is what we call cretinism. The cretinism is caused due to the hypothyroidism during fetal life, infancy and childhood. Here the child will have stunted growth, mental retardation, and there will be a enlarged and protruded tongue, there will be a non-development of sexual organs, low BMR, stunted growth, and there will be a reduced appetite, ugly looking child, these will be seen. So the maternal iodine deficiency causes this cretinism. The treatment is supplementation of hormone thyroxine. Coming to the other conditions like hyperthyroidism, before hyperthyroidism there are also called as goiters. A condition enlarged thyroid gland is called goiters due to the iodine deficiency. Endemic goiters occurs in the people living in the areas like Himalayan regions because the lack of iodine causes T3 T4 decreased production and increased secretion of TSH causes thyroglobulin. Accumulation of thyroglobulin causes the enlargement of the gland. Non-endocrine endemic goiters also seen in persons with the iodine uptake is normal, but there is a deficiency of enzymes involved in the synthesis of T3 and T4. leads to this condition called non-endemic goitis. Coming to the hyperthyroidism, here we are showing the patients of hyperthyroidism. Excessive secretion of T3, T4 level leads to a condition called Graves' disease. The clinical features of this disease are exophthalmos. Exophthalmos is a protrusion of the eyeball caused due to the inflammation of the edema of the retroorbital structures. The treatment is surgical removal of thyroid gland, use of anti-thyroid drugs, radioactive iodine therapy for destruction of the gland. So that is what we call exophthalmos. The other features which are also seen in the diagram, that nervousness, tremors are seen. Fine tremors are characteristic feature of hyperthyroidism. Increased cardiac output, systolic blood pressure, increased resting pulse rate, intolerance to heat and excessive sweating, increased BMR, hyperglycemia and decreased cholesterol, weight loss, polyphagia and diarrhea. These are the common items which are seen in the patients of exophthalmos, fine tremors, tachycardia, intolerance to cold, intolerance to heat, increased BMR, hyperglycemia. With all these decreased cholesterol level, we can diagnose the hyperthyroidism. The treatment is surgical removal of thyroid gland, use of antithyroid drugs or radioactive iodine therapy. There is another condition called inflammation of thyroid gland which leads to called Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Hashimoto's thyroiditis is an autoimmune disorder. It is caused due to the production of antibodies more against the thyroglobulin, which destroys the gland, and that is called Hashimoto's thyroiditis. So overall, you must remember the three important conditions. One is called as Graves' disease, hyperthyroidism. The second is called exophthalmos, which is shown the Graves' disease, and mixed edema, which is shown in the hypothyroidism state, and in cretinism, which is seen in children. Children looks idiotic look, pot belly appearance, mental retardation, and sexual growth will not be there. So that is how we can diagnose the case of cretinism. So these are the various clinical disorders, hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism causes various disorders. So that completes the thyroid gland physiology, its actions, its metabolic actions, how it acts on the various parts of the body, and what are its clinical aspects, hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism. That completes in short the thyroid gland. Thank you very much. Over, sir. Sir?
Okay, sir. Oh.
The slide bhi khatam hai. Thank you, slide kar ke nahi. Hi. Main wajah pass kiya kyunki wo